Good morning and welcome to your Eagle Nest Live for your AHS Morning News for today, Tuesday, April 13th. Around 10:15 today, the Apollo Girls Swim Team will begin competing in the Regional Swim Tournament at the Health Park. We wish you all the best of luck. The Apollo Tennis Teams dominated Cloverport last night at Moreland Park, both teams winning 5-0. Mia Lampert crushed her opponent, winning 6-0. Other winners were Katie Rice, Sophie Jennings, Maddie Wall. Pri Patel won at number one singles for the boys, and other winners were Maddox Tucker, Jake Patton, and James Franny. Congratulations, tennis team. ESS offers studying, makeup testing, and homework help in science, math, and English several times throughout the week. Students should speak with their teachers or stop by the AHS library for more information. Attention first semester AP Gov students. Mr. Poff will be hosting review sessions for the AP exam beginning this Wednesday, April 14th. The sessions will be from 3:30 to 4:30 in Mr. Poff's room, room 304. Please see Mr. Poff if you have questions. And now, Bailey Hare has a library reminder for all of you.
Students, check the due date slip on the back of your library book to see when your library book is due. Return or renew your book on time to avoid the 5 cent per day overdue fine for each day your book is late. Stop by the library if you have any questions.
Go check out the greenhouse for all of your spring plant needs.
Attention juniors and seniors. OCTC will be having a scrub craze on Friday, April 16th from 8 until noon at OCTC. Juniors and seniors who are interested in surgical technology are invited to participate. There are only 8 spots left for Apollo students, so act quickly if you want to participate in this hands-on event. Please contact Ms. Christy Dame in the guidance office for more information.
Hey Eagles, so most of you might not know, but there's a job board at the front of the Commons area. The job board is there for students in need or want of a new job. The jobs get changed about every 3 weeks to make sure all jobs are still current.
And you can come straight to it if you need a job.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Keelan, and I'm the Youth Service Center Coordinator here at Apollo High School. With summer coming up, a lot of students are going to be looking for summertime employment. So we changed it up a little bit, and now we have what we call a QR code posting. So if you look at one of the flyers, there will be a QR code. So you take your phone and you just scan it, and that will directly take you to the website where you can apply for the job.
I hope the information in this video helped you understand a little bit more about the job board. If you have any questions, contact Ms. Keelan at the email below.
Yes, that was good!
Thank you.
Breakfast and lunch are free for all DCPS students this entire school year. Apollo Virtual students working from home can pick up curbside meals at Apollo High Schools on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays from 11 until 12. For those in the building, our lunch menu for today is, in the Mama's Kitchen line, chicken nuggets and mashed potatoes. In the Sub and Salad line, salad bar. In the Global Fare line, Crispitos or pizza. In the Sandwich line, a choice of cheeseburger, peanut butter and jelly, sriracha, chicken, or spicy chicken sandwich, and french fries, and cookie is a dessert of the day. We would like to wish the following co-curricular activities good luck as they participate in events this evening. The girls' swim team as they compete in regional competition, the boys' and girls' tennis teams as they play Owensboro at the Owensboro Tennis Court at 4, the freshman baseball team as they host Muhlenberg County at 5:30, and JV and varsity baseball team as they travel to play Muhlenberg County at 5:30, and the girls and boys track team as they host their first meet on Apollo's new track at 5 p.m. Thank you, and have a wonderful Tuesday in Eagle Nation.
Good morning, Eagles, and yes, welcome to your Tuesday. Today is April 13th, second day back from spring break. I wanted to give you a few reminders today. First of all, the COSA exam today. Teachers, you have a list of students involved, and you students involved should know who you are. So teachers, please help us out and make sure that our students are getting to the media center here when they are supposed to. Also want to remind everyone that we reinitiated EFT just before spring break. And at this point, from now until the end of the year, or until further notice at least, we are going to have EFT days on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So yes, we will have EFT today. Just a reminder that when we have EFT, we are taking the time out of fourth period, so no other class periods will be affected. The fourth period will end at 2:45. You will hear a special notification to indicate that we are headed for EFT. And so go to your EFT rooms by 2:50. And just a reminder too that we've adjusted our dismissal times now that we are the A's and B groups are all together at the same time. 3:15 is when we are dismissing our drivers and those who ride with our drivers. So please help with dismissal times. There's something else that I want everybody to help us out with, including the adults around the building. You know, 3 weeks ago, we were just so happy to see you all in the building at the point that, honestly, when the school year began, we started out in red status and didn't have any students in the building at all. So when we reached a point that we were just having the A's or the B's in the building, we were happy to see you, even more happy to see you when you came 2 weeks prior to spring break. But there's one policy that I feel like, as I've walked around the building, have had some incidences myself in the office where students are getting to a point where you are distracted by your cell phones. Just want to remind everybody that we still have a cell phone policy. We still have, in our teachers' classrooms, we have some cell phone caddies that are still sitting on desks, not being used. We have caddies on the walls in some of our classrooms as well. If cell phones reach a point that they are that much distracting you from the educational process during the day, I want to remind everyone that we absolutely have the right to take your property, being your phone. So we don't want this to pick up again and be the problem that it was before we initiated this new cell phone policy. So I'm asking everyone these last 7 weeks of school to work hard at trying to maintain a no distraction zone while you're in class. We will be absolutely reasonable about those expectations as long as you follow them and respect those. So let's keep that in mind, and hopefully between now and the end of the week, it won't be any more of a problem than what it's been. We will keep you posted on that. So please help with the cell phones. As far as birthdays go today, On this Tuesday, April 13th, Jonah Hinton, Wayne Rowland, Travis Setzer, Kaylee Sipla, all celebrating birthdays. Let's make it a great day in the Big A.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.